Hello friends, welcome back to our tutorial, Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in Revit 2018 Imperial. If you did the previous tutorial, go and open the file 00_010_BIADVI you save it. If not, you can go and download this file to my website or you can just sit down and follow along. Select these two construction lines and press the delete key on your keyboard. Go to the view control and click the top view. Hover the mouse cursor to custom model view and select first floor plan. Now we're going to modify this plan to the first floor plan. So select these two lines and go and create a new layer, or let's use the cabbage layer to create a temporal line because we are not going to need this line in this way, but we need to create a reference line because we need to draw a roof into this area. So select the polyline command. Unlike the line, the polyline can allow you to draw a straight line and arc, and all the line that you draw in a polyline consider to be AutoCAD treat it as one object. For example, if I select the line command, I draw something like this. I have drawn three lines. But if I use the polyline and draw something like this, I have drawn one object. Now you see, the line command, all the objects I draw with the line command are three different lines. But the polyline is one continuous line. Now I'm going to erase these lines. So go to the home tab, drop and select the polyline command. Zoom in into this area and start a line from this point to this point, this point, this point, and move your mouse cursor. Hover the mouse cursor here and here. Move the line slowly and click. Press escape to get out of the command. Now use a window selection. Not a crossing window, a window selection. You will learn more about selection in upcoming tutorial. And select this portion, click erase. When you use a window selection, you can select all the entity that lies within the windows completely. For example, if I select this, only the object that lies within this window completely will going to be selected. Let me press escape. But if I use a crossing window selection, I select this way, all the object that lies within the window completely will be selected, plus those that partly selected with the window, you see. So the difference is that the selecting window can select everything that lies entirely in the window, and the crossing window can select everything that are entirely in the selection or touch the selection. So use a selecting window to select this line and erase them. Select this and click the delete key on your keyboard. Now go to the home tab, layer panel, and click the isolate button. At the prompt, select object on the layer to isolate. Select this object and press enter. AutoCAD isolates the kitchen layer. Select all of these objects and erase them. Now to bring the objects back, the other objects back, go to the home tab, layer panel, and click the on isolate button. AutoCAD display all the objects that have been hide with the isolate command. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the fillet command. Type R for the radius option and press enter. For the distance, enter 0. Then type M for multiple option. Select this line and this line, this line, this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select these lines, this line, and erase them. Select the fillet command again. Select this line and this line. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 16 feet on your keyboard and press enter. Select this line and offset it down. Select this and offset it to the left. Go to the fillet command and fillet this through line. Press escape to get out of. Select the offset command again. Type 6 inches for the offset distance. Offset this line down and offset this line to the left. Go to the home tab, modify panel and click the down arrow next to trim and select the extend command. Press enter. Extend this line, this line, this line, this line, and press escape to get out of the command. Now select this two line and erase them. Select the extend command, this line and this line, press enter. Select these two lines to extend them. Press escape to get out of the command. Select the extend command again and select this line. Press enter. Now select these two lines to extend it. Press escape to get out of the command. Select this door and use the move tool. At the specified base point prompt, use this endpoint as the base point and move this line to this corner. Select this line and select the move tool. Move this line to this corner. Now click the down arrow after extend and select the trim command. Press enter. Trim off this line. This line, this line, this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Select the plant and these lines, the windows, and hit delete on your keyboard. Go to the home tab, layer panel, and select the make current button. Select this veranda and start the line command. Draw a line from this point to this point. Press escape. Now zoom in, select this line, and hit delete on your keyboard. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the offset command. For the offset distance, enter 2 inches and press enter. Select this line and offset it inside. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the fillet command. Select this line and fillet it to this line. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the save as command. This will bring the save drawing as dialog box. Rename this drawing to 00_011_BIEB and click the save button. This way you will not override the previous work. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 16 feet on your keyboard and press enter. Select this line and offset it down. Select this line and offset it down 6 inches. Press enter. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the fillet command. Type M for the multiple option and press enter. Select this line and fillet it to this line. This line, fillet it to this line. This line, to this line. This line, to this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select these two windows and the endpoint of the wall line into this position and this position. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the move command. At the prompt specifying base point, use the endpoint as the base point. Now move your mouse cursor down and use the perpendicular object snap and snap down. Not this line, but this one at the bottom. Click to place the window. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the trim command. At the prompt, select source object or all, press enter. Trim off this line, this, this, this. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select this line, this short line, this line, this line, and erase them. Go to the home tab and click the down arrow after the modify in the modify panel and select the joint command. Select this line and this line, press enter. Go to guard weld the two points. Press enter to repeat the same command. Select this line, and press enter. Go to guard join the two line. Now select this two line and click this grip. Move it down to the vertical direction. When you see a perpendicular object, now click. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the save button. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select offset. For the offset distance, type 6 feet on your keyboard and press enter. Zoom in into this area, select this line and offset it down. Select this line again, move down and type 6 inches on your keyboard, press enter to get offset the line. Now, click the down arrow after trim and select the extend command. Select this line, and press enter. Extend this line, hold down your shift key and select this line and this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Select the dining table and delete it. Now select this door and move it into this position from here to here. Then use the flip arrow to flip it inside and select the move command again. Use this endpoint as the base point. Move it to this endpoint. Select the door. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the rotate command. At the prompt, specify base point. Click here. Now move the door into this direction and click. Select the door again. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the move command. Select the door and move it at the perpendicular of this point. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 3 feet on your keyboard and press enter. Offset this line down 3 feet. Click the down arrow after extend and select the trim command. Press enter. Trim off this line. Hold down your shift key and extend this line. Now trim it off and trim off this line. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the fillet command. Type M for the multiple option and press enter. Select this line and this line. This line and this line. Again, you have a short line in this area. Use a window selection, not a crossing window. Selecting window, select, select this object and erase them. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 4 feet on your keyboard and press enter. Select this line and offset it out. Select this line, type 6 inches and press enter. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the fillet command. Type M on your keyboard for the multiple option and press enter. If your radius is not set to 0, change your radius to 0. Select this line, this line, this line, and this line, this line, this line, this line, and this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 6 feet on your keyboard and press enter. Offset this line down, select this line and offset it and move it down. Type 6 inches on your keyboard and press enter. Press escape to get out of the command. Select these two windows and delete them. Then go to the home tab, modify panel and select the fillet command. Type M for the multiple option. If your radius is not set to 0, enter the radius option by clicking the radius on the status bar and change its distance to 0. Select this, fillet it to this, this, and this. Press escape to get out of the command. Now go to the home tab, modify panel, select the trim command. Press enter. Trim off this line and this line, this line, this line. Press escape to get out of the command. I shouldn't trim this point, but that's okay. I'm going to select this and this and erase them. Then I use the fillet command to fillet this line and this line. Use the trim command, press enter, and trim off this portion. Press escape to get out of the command. Select this extend excess line and delete it. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 2 feet 6 inches and press enter. Select this line and offset it inside. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the trim command. Press enter to accept all options. Hold down your shift key. When you are in the trim command, you can hold down the shift key to temporarily to transparently switch to extend mode. Hold down your shift key and click. Now click the unwanted areas. Click this area here, and press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab and click the down arrow after modify and select break command. Select this line and move into this point. AutoCAD break this line into two parts. Select the fillet command, fillet this line to this line. Now I'm going to select all of these tiers, then go to the home tab, modify panel, and use the mirror command. I'm going to use the midpoint object snap and move into this direction and click. Press enter to accept the default option. Select this line, repeat the mirror command, use this midpoint and move. Press enter to accept the mirror line. Use the fillet command to fillet this line and this line. Select these two, three objects and press to delete. Now I'm going to select this door, this, and click the delete key. Select this and delete it. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the joint command. Select this command, press enter. Go to the home tab, layer panel, and click the make current button. Select the stairs and start the line command. Go to the status bar and turn on the polar tracking. Click this down arrow and make sure that you place a check mark on the 45-degree increment. Start the line command and click from this point and snap to 45-degree increment. Press escape to get out of the command. I need to move this line backward a little. Select this, click here, and click here. Select this line and this line, press enter. Select this, click to trim off this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Select this excess object and erase that. Now select this window. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the copy command. At the prompt, specify base point displacement mode prompt. Use the endpoint object snap and click here. Move the window into this direction and click. Press escape. The window is bigger than the opening, so select the window and change its distance to 2 feet 6 inches. Press escape to deselect the window. Select this door and go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the copy command. At the prompt, specify base point or displacement mode. Use the base point to grab this door here and move this door from this point to this point. Press escape to get out of the command. Select the door and use the rotate command. Use this as a base point and click here, place the door. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the save button. Now we need to place another window sills in this area, but I want the distance from the window to be the same as this one. So I'm going to use the measure command. The distance from this point to this point is 3.5 inches. So go to the home tab layer panel and select the make current button. Click to make this the 2D wall layer as a current layer. Start the line command. At the specifying first point, type T, K, and press enter. Click here and move into this direction. Type 3.5 inches and press enter. Now press enter to start the line at this point. Move down and type 1 foot on your keyboard and press enter. Move to the right, type 4 inches, press enter. Move up and type 1 foot on your keyboard, press enter to end the command. Now select the tree line that you just draw and select the mirror command. As a specify first point of a mirror line, use the endpoint object snap of this line and click, and move down and click again. To be more precise, turn on the auto mode by pressing the F8 key or click the auto button on the status bar. Press enter to accept the default no option. Now type trim on your keyboard and press enter. Press enter again, trim off this excess portion. Press enter to end the command. Go to the home tab layer panel and select the make current button. Click this object. Start the line command. Start a line from this point to this point to this point. Press escape to get out of the command. Now go to the home tab modify panel and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 54 inches or 4 feet 6 and press enter. Select this line and offset it down, then select this line again and type 30 inches or 2 feet 6, press enter. Go to the home tab modify panel and select the trim command. Select the two line that you just draw and the two vertical line, press enter. Clean up this area. Press escape to get out of the command. Select the offset command. Type 18 inches or 1 foot 6 on your keyboard. Press enter. Offset this line up. Select this line again. Type 3 feet on your keyboard or 36 inches and press enter. Select the extend command, the trim command. Select this line and these two lines. Press enter. Hold down your shift key and extend this line. This line. Select and erase this. And again press escape. Select the trim command and press enter. Trim off this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select the offset command and type 2 feet on your keyboard. Press enter. Offset this line inside the room and select the offset command again. Type 4 inches, press enter. Offset this line inside. Offset this line down. And offset this line up. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the fillet command. For the fillet distance, type M for the multiple option. And fillet this line here to here, here to here, here to here. Here to here, here to here, here to here. Press escape to get out of the command. Select this line and use the midpoint object snap. Snap at the midpoint of these 2 points. Go to the home tab utility panel and click the down arrow. Select the distance command. I'm going to click here. I want to know the distance from this point to this point. That's okay. Press escape. Now go to the home tab modify panel and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 30 inches or 2 feet 6 on your keyboard. Press enter. Select this line, offset up. Select this line, offset down. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select the trim command. Add the select object or select all prompt. Press enter. Select this object. Press enter to get out of the command. Now select this line and erase them. Go to the home go to the Quick Access toolbar and select the match property. Select this line and use a window selection to select and change all this property from the wardrobe layer to the 2D wall layer. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select the trim command in the modify panel and select enter to clean up the drawing. Trim all the area that need to be trimmed. Press enter to get out of the command. Now select this door and go to the home tab modify panel and use the copy command. At the prompt, specify base point or displacement mode. Use the endpoint object snap and use this as a base point. Then copy this door into this area and copy this door into this area. Press escape to get out of the command. You see the door is smaller for the open. So click this grid and change the width to 3 feet and click the flip arrow to flip it into this direction. You can change the opening of the door by clicking this and change it to 45 degrees, or even open this particular door into 90 degrees. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select this window, go to the home tab modify panel and select the copy command. At the prompt, specify base point or displacement mode. Use the midpoint object snap and grab this block at the midpoint. Copy this block to the midpoint of this slide door. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select all these objects and hit delete on your keyboard. Use a window selection to select these two objects. Hit delete. Now select this line, this, and this. Hold down your shift key and click this grid. Click this grid. The grid turned red. Click this grid. Now release the shift key. Click this grid once more and move it. When it snap, release. AutoCAD move the object into the new location. I'm going to create a tutorial which is focused on how to edit with the grips. Now hold down your shift key and click this grip, this grip, this grip. Release the shift key, click this grip and move it into this point. Press escape to deselect this object. Go to the home tab modify panel and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 13 feet 7 inches and press enter. Select this line and offset it down. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select these two lines. Go to the home tab modify panel and select the offset command. At the prompt, specify base point or use the endpoint of this line and move it down. Select this line and hit the delete on your keyboard. Go to the home tab modify panel and select the fillet command. At the prompt, select first object or undo polyline radius trim multiple prompt. Type M for the multiple option and press enter. If your radius is not set to zero, use the radius option and set it to zero distance. Select this, and this. Press enter to end the command. Now go to the home tab modify panel and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 6 feet on your keyboard and press enter. Select this line and offset it here. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab modify panel and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 11 feet on your keyboard and press enter. Select this line and offset it now. Press escape to get out of the command. Now go to the quick access toolbar and click the match properties command. Select this, at the prompt select destination object, select this tool line. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select the fillet command and fillet this tool line together. Go to the home tab modify panel and select the trim command. Select this line, press enter, hold down your shift key and select this line and trim this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 2 inches on your keyboard and press enter. Select and offset this line 2 inches inside, offset this line 2 inches up. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the fillet command. Select this line and fillet it to this line. Go to the view control and click the top. Hover the mouse cursor to custom view and first floor plan. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the save button. In this tutorial, we will modify the ground floor plan to the first floor plan. In the next tutorial, we're going to place some symbol and delete the symbol that's not necessary in this plan. If you find this tutorial useful, please click the like button and share it to your friend. If you have any question or you have a comment or you want a specific tutorial for your purpose, please leave a comment below. If you want to follow along in this series or you want any other tutorial in my channel, please subscribe. Thanks very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next tutorial. Goodbye.